Hello everyone and welcome to another video of Super Teacher, where we'll be discussing on how to attempt this All India CBSE mock test, which is gonna be completely free for you, right? So if you are a grade 10 student, I would request you to kindly share the registration link to every one of your classmates out there. We have discussed what is the syllabus and what are the type of questions that you can expect and what is gonna be the exam pattern of this mock test as well. So let's look at how to attempt the All India CBSE mock test on mobile phones, tablets, as well as on the laptops. So you can attempt it on your Android mobile or iOS mobile, or if you are a person who would like to take the test on a laptop or a tablet, yes, you can also take it. Let this not visible in any case. Then if you are there on the app, what you need to do is go to the batch and click on the All India CBSE mock test. Once you're there, in case after clicking on it, if you're not able to see any tests over there, you just need to hold the screen and just drag it downwards. So when you do that, the entire page of the app gets refreshed and your test will be visible over there. From there, you can click on it and you can start taking the test. Right, so if you are there on the browser and if it is not visible in that case, then you just need to refresh the page by just clicking on F5 button on the keyboard. Once it refreshes, you will be able to see the test. Just remember this: whenever you feel that the test is not visible to you after going to the test option, you will have to drag downwards. Just then you will be able to refresh the page on the app. You will be able to see the test over there. Just click on it and start attempting the test. So let's see how to attempt the test on these devices. Probably on Android and iOS it will be the same. On a browser, I'll be able to show you right now. Yeah, we'll show on Android and iOS first. And once you open the app, you will have to input the organization code CAPA for iOS. And then input the mobile number. Then you will receive an OTP on the mobile number. Just input the OTP, 4-digit OTP. And you will be able to log in. So this is how the app interface look like. Then click on the badge icon which you are able to see below. The moment you click on that, you will be able to see All India Mock Test CBSE badge. Click on that and click on the test on top. The moment you click on that, you will be able to see the test over there. Click on it and start taking the test, and then we'll look at how to attempt the test on a browser. So initially you need to go login.superteacher.in. initially you need to visit this page if you're taking from a browser on a laptop. Here you need to provide your mobile number. Whatever 10-digit mobile number you wanted, you can give. Click on proceed securely. Then it will send an OTP to your mobile number, the one which you have given, and you have to type the 4-digit OTP over there to sign in or log in to the web page. So this is the website, and here you will be able to see on the left hand side there is something called as batches, and you will be able to see this All India CBSE mock test. So you just need to click on that, and on the left hand side you can see all the other things like overview, announcements, attachments, video and all that. Just click on tests and you'll be able to see All India mock test. For now, this is for demo purpose, that's why we are showing this as basis and solves, but you'll be able to see the questions. Just click on I agree and click on attempt the test, and the questions will start. Just need to click on select the option and click on save and next. Don't click on submit test. So you just need to click on save and next every time. If you want to make a review, you can keep it for review as well. So it will show you the number of review questions over there. And then whatever you wanted to select with the options, you can just select, and if you want to mark it for you, you can do that. You can select the option over there and click on The last question will have only submit option. So before submitting, you just need to check how many review questions are there for you to review. Just click on it and you will be able to see the questions to review. Give the answer for that, and then finally you can check how many questions are there for review, and then click on submit the last question. Once you click on submit, it'll show the number of questions which are attempted, number of questions which are answered, right, and total number of questions, the questions which are answered. Then click on submit. Once you submit the test, you will not be able to come back. So just remember, ensure that you click on submit only after giving answers to all the questions. That's it. The score will be displayed immediately after the test, and you can see the number of incorrect answers or unattempted questions, the questions which are attempted and all that. Let's see what are the precautions that we need to take when you are attempting the test. You should not open any tabs, or you should not switch between any applications. For example, if you are there on the Android app, if you have any other apps which are opened in your recent apps, you're not supposed to switch between the applications. So when you're taking the test, do not switch between any other applications. The same is applicable for participants who are taking it on the browser, right? So do not open any other tabs. First two attempts, you try to open any other tabs or applications, it'll throw you a warning actually, saying that you will be disqualified. And the third time, test will end automatically. So just do not try, you know, switching the tab or applications, otherwise you will be disqualified. And if you're doing it for the third time as well, then you will be completely thrown out of the test automatically. There will be a save and next button and also submit button. The submit button is where you need to click at the end of the test, and every time you just need to click on save and next option. So let's say you are there on a question, and you just figured out the answer to be any of the options A or B or C or D. You just put that, you just click on it and then click on save and next. That means your option which you have given is saved for that question. So you just click on save and next, it'll be saved and you will be moved to the next question. Initially you can take all the easy questions, and whenever you feel that you need some more time to answer them, you can just mark for review and then come back later and attempt those questions which you marked for review. Ensure that you attempt all the questions, because there is no negative marking. And 4 hours after completing the test, a detailed analysis would be enabled for the participant to view on the app. So immediately after submitting, you will get your test scores. But if you want a detailed analysis of where your strengths are, where your weaknesses are, then you'll have to download the app. There you'll be able to look at the detailed analysis of the report as well, right? So there'll be 40 marks, and 90 minutes will be given to answer just 40 questions. So that means like you will be getting around 2-2.5 minutes for answering a question, right? So I feel that that should be more than enough, right, considering these as MCQ questions. And if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, do subscribe to the same. The name of it is Super Teacher Space Official Channel. So you'll be getting a lot of interesting updates related to the CBSE exam pattern for the academic year 2021 and 20. What are you waiting for? Just click on the subscribe button and do subscribe for our YouTube channel. Coming to our app here, this is our app, that is Super Teacher Official Live Learning app, where you can download it directly from the Play Store. And once you download, you'll be able to see the detailed report of your mock test results as well. So where your strengths are, where your weaknesses are, all those will be completely discussed or completely seen in a detailed analysis report over there. And then if you are an iOS user, yes, we do have, we do cater to iOS as well. That is My Institute is the name of the app. Once you download this My Institute app on your iOS devices from the App Store, you'll have to use the organization code called as KAPA. Once you use that, you'll be able to look at the detailed report of your result as well of the mock test. That's it. Thank you very much. Hope to see you in the next video. Take care. Bye bye. Stay safe.